Okay, when you are contacted by one of these outside substances, foreign substances, the contact leads to a set of reactions. This is what I'm getting at today. Three reactions that happens in this set. And if we will parallel them with our soul, we'll be able to have a reaction to sin. That's not your normal reaction. What happens is, white blood cells produce antibodies according to the substance or the invader. So, according to if it's pollen or according to its bacteria or maybe venom. You know, Brother Robert got bit by the snake, and you know, goodness gracious, he had the worst time of that. Where some people might not have been as bad. We hear people all the time it's been bit 10 or 11 times. Well, not if they would not have been bit the second time if they went through what Brother Robert went through. Do you agree? Do you understand? Brother Robert is still not over this. If you've been as sick as he was, his body did not react very well to venom. I mean, I don't know that anybody does, but I think some are worse than others. And I believe he had a hard time. Now, we understand that. So what he's saying is our white blood cells and our immune system, they begin to formulate to whatever the invader is and begin to use whatever's necessary to attack that certain foreign object. You understand today that Jesus Christ has left us the Word for just that. It doesn't matter today if it's the flesh or if it's the eyes or if it's the ears or the mouth. It doesn't matter what Satan is after you with. It doesn't matter if you think it's one of them big sins or one of them small sins. Jesus has the Word for the antidote. Whatever mixture you need, whatever advice you need, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what Satan comes up with. God Himself has a verse for you. Do you understand that? When we get attacked by sin, whatever it is, it doesn't matter if it's something going on in your marriage, it doesn't matter if it's something going on in your work, it doesn't matter if it's something going on in your personal life, whatever it is, the Word is the living Word. And that means it doesn't matter how many years go by from the time that the book was written to the time that Jesus comes back. He's got the answer for whatever Satan comes up with. Everything that has been good, I have seen Satan manipulated. Even if God give it to us, Satan would find some way to get in there and manipulate it. Even the Bible. You've seen the Word of God even be manipulated. You see today that translation after translation after translation after translation after translation comes out.
Yes,
as many more we get, yes. Man, it's going to get further and further and further and further away from the truth. There's places in my Bible right now that are in other Bibles that leaves out the Word of God. That leaves out His name exactly. Amen. Just skips over or changes God to Him. God ain't Him. God is God.
Amen.
And this is what it's so important. Everything that you're going to get, I promise you, some way, somehow, you can find Satan trying to slip in there.
Yes, sir.
But it doesn't matter what it is, God has the Word. A Word for you. You carry that Bible with you. You put it in your car. You take it to work. It doesn't matter where you are. This needs to be wherever you're at. Get you one you can put in your pocket. It doesn't matter. The Word is made just for that.
Yes, sir.
God left the Word to get us out of trouble. God give us the Word to speak to whatever's going on in our life. No matter what Satan tries today, God and the Holy Spirit can lift you up and direct you by the Word.
Amen.
So today when sin starts to try to invade you, the space that God has claimed, you say amen.
Amen.
Then you claim it.
Amen.
And when that sin starts to try to invade you, I want to tell you something today. The first place you go to is God. The first place you go to is His Word. You get that thing out. and start reading. I'm going to tell you that no matter what sin, my brother Rob, when I was, you know that when I was going to church, I was under Brother Robert, and I started to go on a date, and he said, okay, you can go, as long as you take Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. What? He said, you put that Bible right between you and that girl in that truck, and he said, you ought to have a hard time crossing Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John to do something you're not supposed to do. Amen? Take the word with you. It doesn't matter what it is, that Bible. It is our word from God. Now, whatever, when that word, when something starts to try to get your attention and you recognize it, you recognize that it's sin. I want to tell you, that sin is not there to befriend you. That sin is not there to do something good for you. You know, I had an allergic reaction one time to something medicine I took, and I started scratching all over myself, and I turned red. Remember, it wasn't very long ago. I took a Tylenol with another thing, and it had a lot of scratching and turned red. I was working back there in the bathroom, and man, I started just turning red spots, and boy, I was just itching, you know, but I didn't let that go on. You know why? Because I knew something, it wasn't good for me. It wasn't there to make me feel good later. It was there to do something wrong. So I sent Kara straight to get some Benadryl. Amen?
Amen.
I was going to do something about that. I wasn't going to let it just carry on. We cannot give sin time or room to do what Satan's plan is.
Amen.
Now, he says, now, this next thing that happens is okay, the antibodies, the white cells, they get whatever form or mixture they need to attack whatever certain substance is coming in. That's our word. There is an answer in our word. Then, the next thing that happens, these antibodies start to promote productions and release of chemicals and hormones. So, in other words, these things, and this mixture starts calling on the other parts of the body, chemicals to be released and production, and all these things are going on. This thing, this just one thing is a whole miracle of God itself. How does this happen? You know, I understand computers, this things and that things, and this comes on, but your body, man, it's amazing. But what happens is these antibodies start calling for help. You know, that's one of the worst things that any of us can do, is think we can handle it all by ourselves. You know, I have made a great example of that several times in my life, where I've tried to run my life like I want. And man, I make a stinking rotten mess that takes God forever to dig me out. You know, because of my consequences of what I've done. Man, every time that I let God run my life, I get something like Joshua. I get something like Kara. Every time that I go according to the will of God, I get something like Pamela. But boy, when I decide I'll do it myself, and I don't care who you are, and I don't care what things you've got going on in your life, if you don't let God run these things, if you don't feel like today that you need help for nothing, I don't even care how much money you got in the bank. You say, man, I'm saved. You're not saved.
That's right.
You're not saved. And man, I have seen it over and over again. You say, why do we have to come to church? Well, you don't have to. I mean, if you don't want to, even though the Bible says, do not forsake the assembling of ourselves to together. Why did we not accept that? We need each other.
Amen.
We need each other. Man, I need to come to church and hear about Annabelle rededicating her life. Woo! I need that.
Amen.
I need to be with my brothers and sisters and sing.
Amazing.
I need to hear it. I need fellowship. I need people praying for me, as I have. You need someone praying for you. We need help. If for us not to call on the people that love us. I try to tell anybody that comes up here to say something or do anything, listen, this is the best place you can be because everybody in front of you loves you. And isn't just going to town, they love you. You're not out in the world where they're going to critique you and critic you and put you in the paper and laugh at you. You know what? You're in a place that everybody comes out is going to be good because they love you. We need help.
Amen.
You need help.
Amen.
As we're taught by the body that God created. God created a body that the antibodies, well, where they take off and then they start calling for help. You know why this happens? Because the body is not going to take no chances. The body's not going to take the chance that this might be just some minor substance or a substance that might kill you. The body's going to take care of it. Now, last point, and I'll let you go. Last point is, what happens is, the white blood cells, man, these chemicals and hormones, they have an effect on these local tissues and organs, which then causes the release of even more white blood cells, which in turn repeats the process over and over and over to stop this process. Well, this process keeps repeating itself until it becomes into an overreaction. I mean, it's produced too many white blood cells. It's produced too many chemicals and hormones and released all this stuff together and just going crazy, and your body has an overreaction to an allergy, which is an allergic reaction. You know what? I'm scared a lot of times when I hear things that are going on in the world and the church don't overreact. You hear that? We should have overreacted when they took prayer out of school. We should overreact when we hear about abortions. We should overreact. We've got to the place where we say, you know, it ain't worth fighting. We don't have a big enough voice. We shouldn't get involved in this. Let's just leave that to the politics. We'll just be separate. We don't overreact no more because we just want to go home. We just want to be left alone. We want to do our part and then let's be over. We don't, you know what? We have said it so many times that we don't want to make somebody mad because we might run them off. How many times have we said that? You know, we don't even overreact no more to sin. We just about get to the point where we don't even react. And sin is sitting around the church today. When we start allowing sin into the church, there's no stopping. We need to overreact. You understand? You see, we're separate from the world. That's what God said sanctification is. He says, I'm going to save you. I'm going to wash you in the blood. I'm going to forgive you of your sins. And I'm going to set you apart from all the other world. Well, that ain't what we want these days. We want to be forgiven, but still be able to do the things we used to do. Or hang around the people we used to hang around. Or dress like we used to dress. But we're not the same. God said we are a new creature.
Yes.
We just don't act any different. We don't react today to Satan's devices, his lies, his deceiving tactics, or his sin. You know what? God didn't save us for sin to continue to be alive. He didn't save us and write our name on the Lamb's Book of Life. That one person come to salvation and the angels rejoice, rejoice, rejoice for us to go on that and do what we've always done. Do you understand that? He called us to be different. You know what Paul said? Paul said in 2 Corinthians 12:11 that he had become a fool in glory. I mean, he went in churches and in towns and they said, man, that guy's an idiot. Why is he such an idiot? Because he loved Jesus so much and he was different than them. And he, boy, when he heard somebody talk about Jesus, he got a little excited. You know, he got to a place where when somebody got saved, he went a little overboard to what normal people might think.
Yeah.
When a little girl rededicates her life, yeah. Paul said, glory! 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 not only did he overreact in glory, somebody tried to offer him sin. He got away as quick as he could. He overreacted according to the world's standard. But to God, it was just right.
Amen.
Listen to me right now. In Titus 2:14, I want you to turn there as I close. Titus is just right down the corner there, or back, or something. Over, forward. Peter, John, James, the other way. The other way. Titus, the great, just right there close. Titus chapter 2, verse 14, it says, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Now listen to that. Who gave himself for us, Jesus died for us, that he might redeem us, that he might forgive our sins. He forgive mine. He went to the cross that he may redeem me from all sin. From all sin. And purify us to himself. Look at it. A peculiar people. So in other words, when he saved me and freed me from the guilt of sin and the consequences of sin, he made me, when he purified, he made me a peculiar person to the world. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't act right. I didn't talk right. I didn't look right. I didn't dress right to the world anymore. All these ways that Satan used to have to get me, the places that he knew I used to go, that he could sit out and wait for me, I didn't go to those places. I wasn't around those. Everybody started talking. I said, man, he's kind of cute. He should have stayed in the church. He acts funny in that place. Yeah. Zealous. You know what zealous means? We like to turn on fire. That's what zealous means. We're on fire to do good works. Did I tell you about Travis the other night? This guy's bugging me to death. I want to do something for Jesus.
Amen.
Called me all the time. Man, Travis. You become peculiar.
Go
to everybody else. God bless you, son.
Amen.
God bless you. You see, first thing we're going to have to do is react. And then we can start getting into some overreaction. The first thing we need to overreact about is the sin that's in our own life. We can overreact to that. We can begin to overreact to these other things that's going on in the churches today, in our communities, in our homes. We need to overreact. You know, God is that good. To overreact. Go above and beyond what the standards of the world say are okay. You know what we do? We make us fool out of ourselves at football game. And then we're slap-bored asleep at church.
Yes, sir.
Now in heaven, that, my friend, is a real fool. Mm. Everybody lost for us.